Now, more than 4 years since a massive explosion and fire killed over 100 people in Kerala's Kollam district, the charge sheet has been filed against a 59 accused. In fact, to get more details on the situation, we have, Sneha Mary Koshi, who is finding out over the 600 people who were injured in this tragedy. She spoke to the Inspector General of the Crime Branch for more.
Well, April 2016 was a shock for people across Kerala, across India, as they saw what was supposed to be a celebration, a ritual, a temple festivity in Puttingal Paravur, that's part of Kollam in Kerala, go up in an explosion, flames. And now there's a charge sheet which has been filed in this particular case. Joining me right now is IG Srijit. He is the supervisor to the investigating officer of this case. This was a case, sir, where over 100 people had died.
109 to be exact.
109. It was a shocking case. What does your charge sheet state?
The charge sheet has been filed under Section 302, that's for murder, and then for handling explosives very carelessly and without authorization. Now, they have been booked under the Explosive Substances Act, Explosives Act, PDPP, that is Protection, Destruction to Public Property, and then, of course, various IPC offences like, I told you, of course, 302 and 307, attempted murder, and so on and so forth. There are 59 accused in all,
okay,
including the temple authorities and all those who actually
including
conspired.
The temple authorities?
Yes. There was
why were the temple officials accused in this case?
They had decided, despite government orders to the contrary, the collector had given orders that this will not take place in the manner in which they had actually envisaged. But they went on with a scheme of things, whatever they had planned, they went on with it. And it resulted in an explosion which killed over 100 odd people. The people who were holding the blast license, those of them who actually attempted and aided and abetted in this blast and the explosion, being a part of it, without being licensed to do so also. That's what I said, they were handling explosives in a very, very callous manner, and they were not supposed to use so much volume of explosives. It's over.
How many?
Around 5,500 odd kilograms of explosives were there, as per the controller's report.
When you're talking about whether they were pre-warned, there were this at that time there were these reports. Even I think there was a committee which was set up also, and they had said about how the refusal to go ahead with this festival was very delayed. Did you find any such thing in your probe?
See. Normally all the precautions which should have been taken has been taken by the district administration. But well, of course, the permission, or rather the permission not being granted, was intimated to the authorities, the temple authorities, on maybe a couple of days prior. And that is fairly good enough. They can call it off any time. So they can't say that they were preparing for this for long in anticipation. They can only prepare after they get proper permission from the government, which was not there at all.
Has your probe also found anything, any errors on the part of the collectors or the district administration or the government? Because that was also something which was spoken about when this incident happened.
As of now, there is no criminal offence which has been taken up against the officers. But well, the investigation might go on if the court decides so on certain other counts, which the High Court has earlier specified.